And this is a quick review of the rec center reopening, a decision package that is part of the budget request. As we have been sharing with you monthly, the renovation is definitely on time and is under budget. We are going to keep it that way. We're doing our best to make sure it is on time and well under budget. The estimated annual expenditures you see on the top there for the 2 years and the projected annual revenues, the recovery rate is approximately 76%. That is a very conservative estimate on the revenues. We've rescrubbed the revenue estimates with a very sensitive look at our market conditions and the downturn in our economy. And on the right-hand column, you see the requested new positions to operate this facility when it becomes operational. An assistant aquatic supervisor, a fitness coordinator, two custodians, and a senior guard, and part-time staff and customer service, and additional lifeguards that are mandated by health codes because of our health codes to monitor the deck and the new aquatic space that we have opening next spring. The key issues that we have on our agenda, as I just mentioned, the recreation center reopening, our healthy communities and potential partnership with the hospital district. We are in the midst of preparing a very comprehensive wellness and health program to be submitted to the hospital district for their review and approval, basically earmarked to combat childhood obesity. And you will be receiving that very shortly from me and my staff. We have been meeting with partners, potential other partners and supporters, and that information will be shared very shortly. Paul mentioned the Lynnwood High School issue. The replacement there is the interlocal agreement that we have with the school district. In park development, the retention of our two state grants, $350,000 is actually the Stadler Ridge grant, and $500,000 is the Doc Hagman grant. Unfortunately, right now our matches on both of those grants are in severe jeopardy due to the REIT funding, which we pledged as our match 2 years ago. The REIT funding is basically drying up, so we are in definite jeopardy of losing those two state grants. College issues, David touched on one that we are working on as a team, the potential sale of the city-owned warehouse, which we are working through right now. And on the golf side, our new business plan and master plan, which we will be bringing to you early next year. A quick touch of the golf course. Some good news. We are going to be very happy to retire a 20-year bond next year, finally completing the $5 million bond in October of next year, which really puts the golf course in a totally different financial picture. Staffing levels, we eliminated two full-time positions last year, and we are now starting to see the benefits of those reductions now this year. I've highlighted August for you to compare August of 2010 to 2009. In August of this year, we were up $40,000 in revenue and down $50,000 in expenses. We are very close to being revenue positive for the golf course this year. Pleased to say that. Decision packages that we have on the golf course, important. The 10th tee building, which would house concessions and storage. Our concessionaire is doing a wonderful job for us at the golf course. We're seeing some spike in rounds. People have been very receptive to our new menu and services. We also need to replace some equipment and the range net purchase, which would protect our neighbors on the 14th fairway. And here's a quick summary of our proposed budget reductions and impacts. As I mentioned, the original proposed budget maintained our 2009 level of service, including pre-existing recreation center operating costs. We have come up with $2.5 million in staffing and operating reductions necessary to achieve our net reduction of $1.8 million. The reason there is because of the revenues. We had to offset the net reduction because we had to factor in the revenues that these programs produce to get to our net reduction level. So in essence, we had to cut almost $700,000 more to reach our target number. We have programs that have been valued by our community, would be reduced or eliminated. Our teen program, our after-school programs, our arts, and our seniors. And our programs with the highest cost recovery would be eliminated. Adult softball, preschool, summer camps. Those are all in the 90-plus percentile of recovery. And as mentioned, our park conditions would deteriorate, brown lawns, diseased landscape, trash, graffiti, reduced restroom maintenance resulting in some discomfort and obviously user dissatisfaction, and potential safety and liability issues. Some new revenue sources that we're looking at, I've shared with you, I am working to find a partner for naming rights for the Recreation Center, working very aggressively to do that, to offset those, offset that gap in the subsidy. We're looking at all partnerships, anywhere we can find partners to do some of the things that we are doing or some of the things that we are going to eliminate. We are looking at increased admission fees at the renovated rec center. We will be bringing to you our comprehensive fee policy analysis later this month. And as mentioned there, the new fee policy revaluing all of our programs. This is for the entire department. Activities, our resident discount differential, cost recovery, and customer demographics are all part of this policy. Our golf course will see increases in fees and green fees and cart rental fees in 2011 and increased golf concessions and tournament revenues to drive more revenue to the golf course to reduce our costs at the golf course. And some parting thoughts, some of our challenges, we've talked to you about diminished resources, deferred maintenance, we still have our deferred maintenance issues, the amphitheater at Lyndale, the boardwalk at Scriber Lake, court resurfacing that we haven't done for 7 or 8 years. But the opportunities that we've worked on to focus on our core and our important activities, reexamining our partnerships, rethinking employee health care and benefits, looking at our sustainable revenue streams, Park District, Metropolitan Park District idea, mitigation fees through park impact fees, and a nonprofit relationship, which I think has lots of potential for us to look at for the future, using the Seattle Parks and Recreation model where a nonprofit has basically been administering their recreation programs for almost 30 years. So those are my thoughts for the evening, and I appreciate your listening to me tonight. Thank you.